فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
Number eight is علوم الحديث. The science of hadith. That's the eighth one's called. Guess who wrote it? Abu Amr, Uthman, Ibn Abd al-Rahman, Ash-Shahrazuri, who is well known for what? Ibn al-Salah, who died the year 643. He died the year 643, rahimahullah. This kitab is well known for the name what? Muqaddamah. Is known as Muqaddamah ibn Salah. Is very famous for what? The name Muqaddamah ibn Salah. The introduction of Ibn Salah. That's what it's known for. وَهُوَ مِنْ أَجْوَدِ كُتُبِ الْمُصْطَلَحِ. You know what? It is one of the best books that have been written in this field. If not the best. He, رحمه الله, what did he do? جَمَعَ فِيهِ مُؤَلِّفُ. The author of this book, رحمه الله, Ibn Salah, what did he do? He brought together ما تفرق في غيره من كتب الخطيب وما تقدمه. All the scholars that came before him, what they wrote, such as Khatib al-Baghdadi, such as what you call it, Qadi al-Iyad, such as Abu Nu'aym al-Asbahani rahimahullah, and others. What did he do? All of their works and the things that they did, he came and he organized it. He brought it together. It's a book, حقيقةً, كتاباً حافلاً بالفوائد. It's a book really filled up of benefits. لكن لم يرتب على الوضع المناسب. But the problem that he has is that the way he organized it is not what? It was not in a good order the way he did it. It's not. The reason is because one cannot be blamed for that is because لأنه أملاه شيئا فشيئا. He dictated it, he didn't write it. It was a dictation he did when he was teaching in the madrasa, where he was teaching in Dimashq. So he used to dictate it to the students, and that is the reason. That book of Amr ibn Salah, is the kitab. Scholars came after it. They made for it من مختصر له وناظم ومعارض له ومنتصر, as Ibn Hajar said. That kitab of Amr ibn Salah, it got abridged. Poetry was made out of it. Who made poetry out of it? Iraqi rahimahullah. Al-Imam al-Iraqi rahimahullah ta'ala, his Alfiya is made from this kitab. وَمُعَارِضِ اللَّهُ, some who supported him. Hawashi were put on it. Muntasir was put to it. People came, and what did they do? People, they were amazed with his kitab. They were amazed with what? His kitab. As I said, Zainuddin al-Iraqi rahimahullah, what did he do to it? Iraqi rahimahullah ta'ala, he made a poetry out of it. Also, Jalaluddin al-Suyuti made a poetry, 1,000 lines of poetry also. Who abridged it? Brothers, it's not a joke. Nawawi abridged it. Al-Imam al-Nawawi rahimahullah ta'ala, he abridged it. Ibn Kathir abridged it. Ikhtisar ulum al-Hadith. Ibn Jama'ah, he also abridged it. Some scholars, what did they do? Istidrakat wa mu'aradat. Some opposed him and they added additional things to it. Like who? العلامة على الدين المغلطاي. He did that. Also زين الدين العراقي. He done a استدراك on the كتاب. تقييدات he added to it. بدر الدين الزركشي رحمه الله. He did the same. حافظ بن حجر also has a nukat on it. رحمه الله تعالى. That كتاب the علماء done, they done طواف on it. طواف. You know طواف? The scholars, they done طواف on it. No, I mean اعتكاف. Scholars, they done on that كتاب اعتكاف. What did they do on it? I'tikaf. And that kitab, haqiqatan, is a book that scholars spent how much time on? They spent a lot of time on. That's the book, number eighth book. Sheikh Muhammad Muhyiddin Abdul Hamid, brothers, pay attention. In the muqaddimah of his Tawdih al-Afkar, he praises that book. I want to read what he said. The kitab Tawdih al-Afkar by Imam al-San'ani rahimahullah. Imam Muhammad Muhyiddin Abdul Hamid. You guys know Muhammad Muhyiddin Abdul Hamid? You guys know him? He's a great alim, wallahi al-azim. He's the man who done the... You guys know Tuhfat al-Sunniyah? Tuhfat al-Sunniyah. تحفه السنيه في شرح الاجروميه. He's the sheikh that done the sharh of تحفه الاجروميه رحمه الله تعالى, which are people accepted. محمد محي عبد الحميد, he was a محقق, very strong man. Look what he said. He said, ولو لم يكن من if it was not من حظوة هذا الكتاب إلا أن يتصدى له الإمام النووي وابن كثير وابن جماعة والزركشي والعراقي وابن حجر حفاظ أزمانهم, ثم لم يكن لهم من حظوة إلا أن يتفرع له الحافظ العراقي الزمن الطويل ليجمع له نكتا واعتراضات له وللشيوخ عليه, حتى إذا أتم كتابه ذلك عاود تلميذه يعني ابن حجر الكتابة مرة أخرى ليضع لهذه النكت وهذه الاعتراضات ذيلا. لو لم يكن من الحظوة لهذا الكتاب إلا ذلك لكان كافيا وكان دليلا مع ذلك على منزلة الكتاب ومنزلة صاحبه. He said, if this book did not have any virtue, any praise or anything to be mentioned, just the fact that Imam النووي, ابن كثير, ابن جماعة, زركشي رحمه الله تعالى, عراقي, ابن حجر, they stood over it. These are not scholars, علماء of hadith stood over it. For what? For a very, very long time. Rather, Ibn Iraqi, rahimahullah, he died, he stood over it for a long, long time, rahimahullah. To do what? Nukat, i'tiradat. Bring, you know, mistakes. He brought it, taqeed wa tawdih. He called it taqeed wa al-idah. Ala muqaddimat Ibn Salah. Adding things to it. Mentioning mistakes that he found in it. Things he didn't agree. Things that he did. When he did it, when he died, who took over? Who did the same? Ibn Hajar rahimahullah. He also did the same. He did what his teacher did before him. To place the same thing. Muhammad Abdul Muhyiddin Abdul Hamid, he's saying, if that book did not have that praise, except that, that's sufficient for this book. That these scholars had done this to it. Rahimahumullah jami'an. May Allah be pleased with them. The ninth book that was made is the Kitab At-Taqrib wa Taysiru li Ma'rifati Sunan al-Bashir al-Nadhir, which is Muhyiddin Yahya ibn Sharafuddin al-Nawawi, rahimahullah ta'ala, Imam al-Nawawi, who died the year 676. That book of Nawawi is the Ikhtisar of the Ulum al-Hadith. That's the Ikhtisar. That is the one he abridged Ulum al-Hadith of Ibn al-Salah. And it's a very good kitab. But the problem it has is that the terminology that Nawawi sometimes uses are what? Slightly hard. Mughlaq al-Ibarah. Sometimes he uses hard words. Also, Jalaluddin al-Suyuti came and he explained the book of who? He explained the book of Nawawi, rahimahullah. That kitab that we mentioned, At-Taqrib wa Taysir li-Ma'rifati Sunan al-Bashir. Suyuti explained it. What did he call it? He called it Tadrib al-Rawi fi Sharh Taqrib al-Nawawi. This is Jalaluddin Abdul Rahman ibn Abi Bakr al-Suyuti, who died the year 911. He explained it very well. After that, who came? After that came is, who also authored in this is Zainuddin al-Iraqi. And Imam al-Iraqi, rahimahullah. Iraq was before Suyuti, rahimahullah. But the reason I mentioned Suyuti is because he explained the book of Nawawi. Okay? Which is the Nazm al-Durari fi ilm al-Athari. Zainuddin Abdurrahim ibn al-Husayn al-Iraqi, who is the teacher of who? Ibn Hajar, rahimahullah. He died the year 806. His book is known for Alfiyat al-Iraqi. Alfiyat al-Iraqi. He made a poetry of the kitab Ulum al-Hadith Ibn al-Salah. He added things to it. He added some benefits to it. In which it wasn't mentioned. And also it has many explanations that are put on it. One of the most common explanation or one of the best explanation is Fathul Mughith, which is the sharh of the student of Iraqi, which is Ibn Hajar's student, Shamsuddin al-Sakhawi, done a sharh on it, which is called Fathul Mughith fi sharh Alfiyat al-Hadith. After that, who came? Ibn Hajar rahimahullah came. Ibn Hajar rahimahullah came, and he authored this book that we're on right now, which is called Nukhbatul Fikr fi Mustalahi Ahli al-Athar rahimahullah. This book, brothers, as we mentioned before, huwa juz'un saghirun mukhtasaran jiddan. It's a small and an abridged book. But wallahi, lakinnahu min anfa'il mukhtasarat wa ajwadiha tartiban. You know what? It is a abridged book. But it's one of the most beneficial abridged books. In terms of even the way it's written. Rather, Ibn Hajar rahimahullah, if you read his sharh with it, He ابتكر فيه مؤلف الطريقة في الترتيب والتقسيم لم يسبق إليها. He printed and organized his book and prepared it. And inshallah, as we go along, we're going to be drawing a diagram, inshallah, in your minds, inshallah, and I'm going to be explaining it for you, how he divides it, and how he brought science of hadith very close to the people. بإذنِ اللهِ الكريم. He also explained his book. He called it نُسْهَةُ النَّظَرِ فِي تَوْضِيحِ نُقْبَةِ الْفِكْرِ. Also came after him is البيقوني. His name is very argued on. Some say his name is called Umar ibn Muhammad al-Bayquni. Some say Taha. We choose the name Taha, inshallah. He died the year 1080. And it's very small book. إذ لا تتجاوز 34 بيتاً. It's how many lines? 34 lines poetry. It's a very small book. Very good. And one can benefit from it. It has a lot of shuruh on it. Last book, بإذن الله الكريم, is قواعد التحديث, the قواعد of تحديث, which was written by Muhammad جمال الدين القاسمي رحمه الله, who died the year 1332. كتاب which is محرر, مفيد. محرر. Like he organized it, very nice. And brothers, there are other books that have been written. We can't mention all of their names. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward all of them good in this world and the hereafter. Naam. So from the way we've looked at the books that we have looked at now, and that we've mentioned that the scholars writ, rahimahumullahu jami'an, some of them were books that were what? As Ibn Hajar rahimahullah mentioned, busitat, meaning it's lengthy. And some of them what? Khtusirat, some of them were summarized. Now, at a conclusion for that point, the ways that the ulama of hadith, the ulama of this science, the way they author their book is two ways. So all those names and all those books, they really revolve around two methods that were used in order to write this science. The first way, tariqatul ula, is at-ta'seelu thumma at-tanwi'u. This is the first way and the first means, which is at-ta'seelu. They put the foundation down and then after that they mention the what? The types that come out of it. So it's the asal first, and then the types come falling under it. So the ta'seel, the asal, the foundation is put in place, and then after that he mentions the types that are out of it. And the people, the scholars that follow these types, who took this methodology, who took this way, is none other than Al-Hafidh Al-Khatib Al-Baghdadi, rahimahullah. In the book that we mentioned previously, Al-Kifayatu Fi Usul Al-Riwaya. He followed that path. He puts the asal down. فَوَا يُؤَصِّلُ أَوَّلًا. First of all, he gives you the foundation. To what? لِلْقَضَايَا الْكُلِّيَّةُ لِهَذَا الْعِلْمِ. He gives you comprehensive rulings for this field that are connected. Such as what? Matters that are pertaining to the adala, the justness of the person who's narrating, the reliability of his, the conditions of that. And then after that, he clarifies for you the usul, the foundation of jarh wa ta'deel. He talks about that. And then he talks about the tasheeh wa ta'leel, the authenticity and the hadith which are defected. After finish all of that, which is the asal, after finishing all of that, what does he do? He starts to mention type after type. Tanawu' wa tafriq wa tafriq li anwa'. He mentions different types. The second tariqah is tariqah tanwi'u. They mention the types, then thumma ta'sil. They mention types, and they say, you know all these types? They fall under this. So they type. And then after that, what do they do to it? The types, they all throw them under what? Under an asal. And that's the path, that was the methodology that was taken by Al-Hafidh Abu Abdullah Al-Hakim Al-Naysaburi in his kitab Ma'rifat Ulum Al-Hadith. That's the path he took. And also that's the path that was taken by who? Al-Hafidh Abu Amr ibn Salah. Abu Amr ibn Salah in his kitab Ulum Al-Hadith. And the majority of the Mutaakhirin, that's the path in which they took. They took this time. They mention يَذْكُرُونَ أَوَّلًا الْأَلْوَعَ. They mention the types first. So they'll say to you what? They say to you Sahih, a type. Then they'll tell you Hassan, the type. And they'll tell you the Da'if, that type. And then from that they build onto that, and they throw it under a type. So that is called at-tanwi'u thumma at-ta'sil. And that's the path that's taken by what? That is the type that's taken by the mutaakhirin. And this is one of the books that follow this path. This book that we're taking. Let's go back to the speech of Ibn Hajar rahimahullah. He said, فَسَأَلَنِي بَعْضُ الْإِخْوَانِ Some brothers asked me, أَنْ أُلَخِّصَ For me to summarize. لَهُمْ For them. To give them a summary, a conclusion. لَهُمُ الْمُهِمُ مِنْ ذَلِكَ The important matters pertaining to science of hadith. Some brothers, my brothers that I love, they asked for me. To author for them what? And mention for them the summary of the most important things of hadith. Brothers, this is called Sababu Ta'lif al-Kitab. The reason why the author wrote the book. Correct? Are you all with me? There are two reasons why scholars would write a book. Two ways. Two. The first one is Su'alu to be questioned by what? Su'alul maqal. A speech is put to him. People write a letter to him. They ask him to author a book. He writes it. Such as the book that we're doing right now, Umdatul Ahkam, Lil Imam Abdul Ghani Abdul Wahid al Maqdisi. He mentions the same. Some brothers asked me to author it. So Abdul Ghani, he authored that book because he was asked it. Ibn Taymiyyah, rahimahullah, he wrote his kitab Aqidatul Wasatiyya because he was asked to do it. Are you with me? Bukhari, he also authored what? His Sahih because he was asked to do it. The idea was suggested to him. The idea was brought to him by his teacher, Ishaq ibn Rahuya. That's if we take one of the views or one of the reasons that scholars mentioned. Some say he had a dream, and some say that Ishaq ibn Rahuya said, if only somebody could write the most authentic book, compile the Prophet ﷺ's sunnah, his traditions, in an authentic book. Ishaq ibn Rahuya said that, and then Ibn Bukhari rahimahullah was sitting there, and he took that on. And some say, no, he was sleeping, rahimahullah, and in a dream he saw himself, with what? He saw himself with a, what's this called? A fan, yeah, a fan. And the flies were coming to the Prophet, and he was like blocking us, you know, like saving the Prophet stuff. So then from that he asked for the dream to be interpreted for him, and he said to him that you would deflect from the Prophet's traditions, you'd be a defender of the Sunnah of the Prophet. So anyways, he took that on and he became a person who authored the most authentic book on the face of this earth. This is what, brothers? Lisa su'alul maqal. Su'al. Somebody sends him a question, asks him, and he does it. The second one is called su'alul hal. No one asks him, but he sees a problem that is in his community. He sees a problem that lies. The situation is as though it came to him and it said to him, write something about me. Are you with me? Like, for example, a person sees the intishar of the zina. Zina spreading amongst the Muslim society. So what does he do? He authors a book in what? In zina and how it's dangerous and the mafasid and the harm that it has and the adrar that it has on the afrad and the mujtama', you know, it has on individuals and it has in society. He mentions it. That is not, maybe nobody came up to him to ask him to write it. This is called lisanu su'ali. It's called su'ali al-hal. Ibn Hajar, rahimahullah, in this kitab, who asked him to author it? Students. Students asked him to author, rahimahullah. Or brothers that he referred to. فَأَجَبْتُ إِلَى سُؤَالِ And then I answered their question. Their request, I accepted it. I accepted their request. فَأَجَبْتُ إِلَى سُؤَالِ I accepted their request. Why? رَجَاءَ الْإِنْدِرَاجِ فِي تِلْكَ الْمَسَالِكِ Pay attention, brothers. He's saying the reason why I did that is because رَجَاءَ hoping to be what? To fall under the scholars who treaded on that path in writing this field. So I can be one of them. Hoping that I can be from one of them. And that is to gain what? The way they gain their reward in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the people are benefiting from their stuff. I also hope, inshallah, أَن يَنَالَ مِنْ أَجْرٍ أَنْ أَلَالَ So I can gain ajr by نشر العلم, by spreading the knowledge I have. Ha. مَا نَالَهُ أُولَٰئِكَ الْمُخْلِصُونَ الْمُتَقَدِّمُونَ The same way those sincere people who preceded me authored in, I also hope the same for myself, he says. فَأَقُولُ I will say, الْخَبَرُ إِمَّا أَن يَكُونَ لَهُ طُرُقٌ بِلَا عَدَدٍ مُعَيَّنٍ أو مع حصر بما وافق اثنين أو بهما أو بواحد فالأول المتواتر المفيد للعلم اليقيني بشروطه والثاني المشهور وهو المستفيض على رأي والثالث العزيز وليس شرطا للصحيح خلافا لمن زعمه والرابع الغريب وكلها سوى الأول آحاد.